Monitoring children's screen habits is essential for healthy development. Now, if you are a parent like I am, you're probably at least have given thought to how much screen time your children should have. If you're not a parent, you've probably noticed your friends, family, others staring at screens all the time to the point where it's hard to even talk to someone. Now, I haven't been single in a long time, but my single friends tell me they go on dates and their dates are half listening to them and half watching their phones. And there's kind of an etiquette now among some people, at least in Manhattan when they're dating, that every half an hour or so, it's considered perfectly acceptable to ignore your date, pick up your phone, and each person kind of looks at it for a couple of minutes, which I think is bizarre. But anyway, let's get back to the kids. There's a lot of research done. There hasn't been any, 20-year studies of screen time because iPads didn't exist 20 years ago. And smartphones didn't really exist 20 years ago. So it's hard to tell the long-term damage or positive effects of kids looking at screen time. Now, there are some things that are indisputable. Researchers found that the average time children spend watching TV or using mobile devices increased from under an hour at the age of 12 months to more than an hour and 50 minutes at three. So the amount of minutes kids are spent looking at a screen each day is dramatically growing up. A study confirmed that children are developing screen habits earlier and earlier, perhaps unsurprisingly, given our increasingly digital-driven world. I know I'm struck sometimes we go out for family dinners with three, four, five other families, and the kids are staring at a cell phone or an iPad with the music loud or the talking loud. They're trying to have a conversation. And the parents act like, well, what do you want me to do? I couldn't possibly ask my child not to look at a screen during a dinner time. To me, that's crazy. And I'm not one of these purists who says, oh, kids should never look at screens. There is a backlash against screens. And supposedly, Steve Jobs and even today, a number of high-tech executives who are making the billions off of people's watching screens don't let their own kids watch screens. I know that in some of the more exclusive private schools in New York City, it is basically a policy. No child is allowed to look at a screen. The parents are not even supposed to let their kid look at a screen other than, maybe for 30 minutes on Saturday morning. And it's almost a code you have to sign to get into the school. I don't know how much of that is truly based on science or if it's just contrarianism. If it's just snobbery. If the masses want this, then I want something else. I'm sure when people went from tablets to scrolls, there were some who said, scrolls, that's too newfangled for me. It's not as permanent as tablets carved into stone. I guess I am someone who likes to think of himself as more agnostic on any one form of communication or format. Print, audio, radio, text, instead focusing on the ideas. To me, it's more important about what ideas is your kid absorbing from the media. There is, of course, a school of thought that says just all the quick editing, the sound effects, boom, 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 a different shot every second is jumbling the brain and keeping a child's brain all stirred up to the point where it becomes increasingly difficult to focus on an actual textbook. I do think there's something to that. I can't prove it, but it feels right. But to me, the answer is not never look at a screen. To me, the answer is yes, spend some time reading books every day. You read to your kids read to you, and spend some time, if they are gonna watch video, looking at videos that are not edited and filled with music and jump cuts every 2 seconds. I grew up, I'm of the era of Mr. Rogers. Some of you heard me talk about that in recent weeks, where Mr. Rogers was the first celebrity I ever saw. First TV studio I ever went to was his in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. His show was very slow, No fancy gimmicks, no special effects, just people talking. I watched that every day as a kid. I really don't think that created cognitive impairment. Well, maybe it did, I can't say impairment. Sesame Street is another one where you've got a lot of educational psychologists designing the show to help kids learn how to think clearly, how to write, how to do numbers, how to do subtraction, addition. I don't know that watching Sesame Street has hurt that many kids. I do think if a kid comes home from school and all afternoon and all evening and all weekend, the kid does nothing but watch the silliest little YouTube videos of people farting and falling on banana peels and hurting each other and falling down, that's gonna rot their brain. Okay, I do think that that's not a good thing, but to me it's about balance. My own daughter, like most kids, absolutely would love to spend every second of the day looking at one of these. So we do put some pretty severe restrictions on it. One of the things we try to do is give her certain times of the day where, okay, you can watch video on an iPad or a TV, but it's going to be something educational. And my daughter loves to watch videos of artists talking about how they paint. I just don't know why that's different than if we hired a professional artist instructor to come talk to her. I realize it's a little bit different, but in terms of damaging her brain development, I don't see that. To me, it's about balance. It's about what you watch. If you read classic literature every night, you're probably going to build your brain and make your brain smarter. You'll have a more interesting, nuanced perspective on the world and history. If all you do is read comic books and you're 50 years old, you're probably not going to have as wide a grasp of history, society, politics, and culture as someone who reads the greatest works of literature. It's about what you are consuming more so than the format. That's my own view. I'd love to hear from you on this subject in future shows, because watching TV is a habit. Watching video, YouTube video, even watching this show is a habit. I would argue it's a good habit to watch this show, but they're all habits that you need to be keenly aware of if you want to be in control of your life. And that's what we're all about.